Thank you so much for tuning in. I am so happy that I get to be back here with you guys. It has been a minute and it is a new year. So it is only right that I wish you a happy new year. I know that's right, honey. It's been some well wishes for this year. For the year 2022, the word of the year is blessings. Yes, blessings on blessings and blessings on blessings, right? That's my word for the year. I am claiming it over my life. I am claiming it over your life. And I really want this year to be filled with blessings in many, many different aspects. Monetary blessings, family relationships that are being built stronger and stronger. That is a blessing. Being able to get a new job, being able to get the business off the ground to the level that you desire. All of those things can be blessings. And of course, health. Hello, health is wealth. Okay, if you do not have good health, you will not be able to enjoy the monetary blessings that the Lord will be sprinkling over you throughout the year. So my first well wishes for you guys is good health. Listen, I will update you guys on the health part later, but for today I'm gonna say that, oh my goodness, my health was tried. Yes, in the past year and a half or so, my health was tried, right? I will not go into details today because that's not the purpose of this video. However, I will say that good health is what I wish upon all of you who watches this, anybody you share it to. I wish that you really have good health so that you can enjoy every single day. You can work on your business, you can have fun and just really live your life abundantly, because that is why Jesus Christ died on the cross for us, so we can live our life abundantly. Second, prosperity. Hello, I really want for you guys to prosper. That's what God wants for us. He wants us to prosper in every area. He really wants us to be living life abundantly and not just simply in your health, but also monetarily. He wants you to have everything in abundance, right? And if we ask, like he says, we will receive. But we have to ask and remain faithful so that we can see the fruition of everything that we're doing, of all the efforts that we're putting towards our business, all the efforts we're putting towards our career, our jobs, everything, so we could see the abundance, so we could see the prosperity within all of these things that we're doing. And then my third thing for you is for you to have a sound mind. So important. Hello, because if you don't have a sound mind, you're gonna be going around here like a chicken with its head cut off, and that is not what I want for you. I want you to have a sound mind within this year so that you can do everything effectively, so you can be a lot more efficient in your business, you could be efficient in your job, you could be efficient in your house and your home life, right? With a sound mind, you will be a lot more efficient. Believe that. And then, so along with the sound mind are some things that you can do for you to be able to maintain or develop a sound mind, to be able to really renew your mind. Hello, mind renewal, to renew your mind on what can happen this year, on the greater things that are awaiting you in this year that you don't even know about. So a sound mind is what I wish for you. I wish clarity in your purpose. And I am going to share some tips on how you can develop each of these things, but I wish that you have clarity in your purpose. In this life, each and every one of us, every one of you who's watching this video, every one of you has a purpose. Yes, you that's watching, you were born for a purpose. You are still here for a purpose. 2020 came to devour, and definitely it did. Hello, can you believe it's been 2 years since 2020 was here? Absolutely, and we are still feeling the impact of the year 2020, because it did a number on all of us, on our health. We lost a lot of people, we lost money, we lost our jobs, we lost our career, we lost our purpose, right? Because we probably feel lost in what was going on. We lost a lot. So there's a lot of us that's grieving, right? The loss of a loved one because of what 2020 did. But regardless of that, there is nothing that you can do about it. It already happened, but there is something that you can do. You can learn to cope. You can learn to grieve. And if you are grieving, my heart goes out to you, and there are resources out there to help you with your grieving process. You already know I'm a therapist. Hello, right? I didn't say that in the beginning because I just assumed that you know who I am. But my name is Wilna. You guys already know that, and you know I'm a marriage and family therapist and certified life coach. So to continue on, I really want you guys to experience clarity on your purpose. I know a lot of people struggle with that. I get a lot of people who said, I don't know what my purpose is, Wilna. I don't really find out what I'm passionate about. I don't really know what I'm supposed to be doing. I don't know what career path I should choose. Well, you are in the right place, people do, okay? I help you live your life and live it to the fullest. I help you to really live in your greatness. I help you to discover the greatness that is within you and live your life abundantly in every aspect of your life. If you ask my past clients this, they will tell you, oh my goodness, every session with her was a handful, because I give you a lot of information, I give you a lot of nuggets, and I will share about that later. But I really wish for clarity in your purpose this year. I want for you to be elevated in all aspects in your life, spiritual life, your family life, your career life, every aspect of your life. I wish upon you elevation. I pray for elevation over your life, and I pray that God really helps you to get to the next level by the end of 2022. Heck, in the middle of 2022, I want you to elevate. I want your mindset to be elevated. I want your finances to be elevated. I want your relationships to be elevated. I want your spiritual life, hello, your prayer life to be elevated in 2022, because honey, there is no more mediocre living in 2022. It is not allowed. It's canceled. Come on now. I want you to be elevated in 2022. And last but not least, I want you to achieve great accomplishments, right? In 2022, I want you to have great accomplishments. I want you to travel. I want you to get that career job that you wanted, that dream job that you want. I want you to open that business that you want to open, that you've been scared to open for so many years. This year is that year. Do not let any other year go by. Don't let 2022 go by without you launching that business, okay? And with that said, I'm gonna give you some tips. I shared that you're supposed to, I pray that you have good health in 2022. What can you do to make sure that you have good health? Drink your water, eat your fruits and vegetables, and exercise. Come on now, four tips. Drink your water, eat your fruits and vegetables, exercise, and let's not forget to go to the doctor, right? Make sure that you go to the doctor, you follow through with what they're recommending. If they're telling you to take it easy, take it easy. Come on now, so that your health can be in its proper shape, because I want you to be able to enjoy this year. In order for you to do that, you need to be in proper shape. The second one that I mentioned was prosperity, right? Prosperity. I want you to prosper. Prosper. In everything that you do. And so in order for you to do that, some tips that I can offer you is to save more. So you can see all the hard work that you're putting in your career. If you're working, you have a job, and you're able to save a little bit more. Pay yourself first, right? So that you can see, okay, I'm working, but I'm seeing, you know, all the efforts that I'm putting out there. I'm reaping the repercussions with prosperity. And then another thing is that business that you have in your heart, launch it. Launch it, honey. What are you waiting for? You need my help, don't you? Okay, with that said, I am gonna give you my information on how you can work with me this year, right? I am working on something very special, and I'm gonna be sharing it very, very, very soon. But I will share that a little bit later. But for today, I really want you to commit to paying yourself first so that you can prosper in all areas and with sound mind. Hello. Everybody needs a sound mind so that you can make better decisions. You could be a lot more efficient in everything that you're doing, and you can appear a lot more professional in your business if you already launched your business. So how do you maintain, or how do you even develop the sound mind? You have to choose peace. this is my new motto, and I've had it in the past before. I choose peace. I refuse to let anybody disturb my peace. I refuse to give anybody that power to disturb my peace, because God has brought me far, and I refuse to allow anybody into my space and disturb my peace. So I choose peace, and that's how I maintain a sound mind. I make sure that I develop a consistent prayer life. So I do my devotions in the morning. 6 a.m. I'm up, I'm reading my Bible, I'm praying, I'm telling God, welcome into my day. Go and instruct me. Instruct my path. Like, make sure that every step I take is directed by you. I do that before I do anything else. I read my Bible, I pray. And then another thing, my husband and I, we pray before we go to work. So I'm very thankful for the consistency. Every single day before we go to work, without missing a beat, we pray with each other, we cover each other in prayer, so that we can have a beautiful day and we can invite God into our day. So that's one way you can have a sound mind, by praying, by choosing peace. And the last tip that I'm gonna give you is to have a journal. Hello, you can have a prayer journal. You can have a journal for just your mental health, for you to process things that you're going through. If you don't have quality people that you can talk to, that you can express yourself to, and even if you do, some things you just want to keep to yourself, a journal. Journaling is very helpful. 5 minutes a day, 10 minutes a day, put it aside. Journal your day. Journal your thoughts. Because if you're keeping everything up here, it's not good for you. So it's good to release it. And one way to do that is by journaling. With that said, hello, I launched my Plan, Pray, and Execute journal in January. And you will get the opportunity to purchase your copy. I'm gonna place the link in the description below so you can grab it. They will be available very, very, very soon. And I am so excited to share them with you. So that's one way that you can maintain a sound mind, is by journaling. And secondly, to clarity in your purpose. A lot of people ask me, former clients and even friends that I, or family that I am in contact with or connected to, they would ask me, how did you discover your purpose? Well, I've been working on that for a very long time. First of all, I had a coach for... So yes, guys, like I was saying before, so that I was able to identify what my purpose was or is, I had to really spend a lot of time in prayer, and I had a coach. I spent time getting to know myself. I spent time identifying what my spiritual gifts were, what they are, and I was able to discover that. And if you were able to compare between what I do now and my spiritual gifts, you could say that, she's really fulfilling her purpose, because I worked on that. I spent a lot of time really identifying that, developing work, relationships with other people who will be able to share tips with me. And that is the reason why I'm so passionate when I work with my clients, whether they are therapy clients, whether they are my coaching clients. I'm very passionate with helping them identify what their purposes are, or even helping them on their journey, really, to be able to continue to walk in purpose and do it confidently. That is one thing that I guarantee that you will develop, is confidence. Because I inspire you, I motivate you, I really am there step of the way to be able to help you to overcome all of these things that you're facing. And lastly, lots of blessing for this year. I really want you guys to experience a lot of blessings. I'm not saying that there will not be hardships. I'm not saying that there will not be temptations. There will not be things that really break your heart. I mean, I can say in the month of January alone, I lost my uncle. I'm still thankful and grateful for life, right? Losing him was very tough. It was very hard. And I'm taking this time to grieve him, to really live, to really allow the memories of him to live on in my life and with me throughout the rest of my life. And so it was really tough for the whole family. But one thing that I can say is that he's no longer suffering, because he was ill for a very long period of time. So God decided to bring him home. So I'm not saying there will not be any loss in 2022. That's not what I'm saying. But I'm saying that you will be better equipped
by developing a more sound mind, like I stated before, by renewing your mind towards all things. I mean, click subscribe right below. Make sure that you subscribe, you like, you share the video so that somebody else can be impacted by the video, so they could be impacted by the information that I'm sharing with you. Don't keep the information to yourself. Don't be selfish. So go ahead and share with them so that they can be blessed. And I'm telling you guys, I'm making a promise to you and to myself first that this year I will be sharing a lot more content with you. I have so many different things in mind. I have so many different things that God has been pouring into my heart about. And literally, it keeps me up at night. It really does. He wakes me down because I don't want to forget it by the time I wake up the next day. So God has been truly faithful. He's been really there in the journey with me. And you will see what I'm talking about once you start seeing these content, honey. I will be posting a lot more often. And I want to build, you know, the subscribers of this page, because I believe that it's not only about the numbers, it's about the impact. And I really want to make a greater impact in your life by sharing more. I will be vlogging. Hello. I will be vlogging. So you will be taken on my journey with me to work, so you could do what I do for a living. You'll see my vacations, vlogs, my lifestyle. I will do get ready with me videos. Pray for me, guys. Speaking of which, there's one coming this week, so watch out for it. All this glam. For this video, I vlogged it, or I recorded it, so you're gonna see my process, what I went through to be able to come before you so fine. So thank you so much for tuning in, guys. All the links will be in the description below. If I forgot something, I'll definitely post it in the comments. And yes, if you received everything that I spoke about earlier, type in I receive so that I can know you really paid attention, one. And then two, that you believe that you receive all of these things. I declare and decree all of these things that I mentioned: good health, prosperity, sound mind, clarity, elevation, and lots of blessings in this year unto your life. So if you receive it, post down, I receive, I receive, I receive. Thank you so much for tuning in once again. Don't forget to like and subscribe and share with your friends, your family, your cousins' cousins. And I'll see you next time for another video. Thank you so much. Have a great one. I'm clocking out, y'all.